Good Thursday morning to you. I'm Teo Torres.
And I'm Deirdre Fitzpatrick. Saving Sports, a community effort underway in Solano County right now to try to keep sports in schools despite ongoing budget problems.
KCRA3 Shara Kina Shams is live in Fairfield with one group's effort and the amount of money they hope to raise. Sharo.
Teo, good morning. We're live at Armio High School this morning where you're looking at a group of runners. This is the track and field team out here actually doing really well this season, heading to section finals later today in Sacramento. But yeah, just as they continue to excel at their sport and continue to excel in school, they're also learning they might not get to run at all next year. This is true for every team on this campus and throughout the district at middle schools and high schools, football, basketball. We're joined live this morning by a basketball player and runner. This is Erica Bossett. So Erica, let's tell people, girl, you have a 4.2 grade point average.
Yes.
You are hoping to go to UC Berkeley, which tells me you are probably hoping for some college athletic scholarships too. But when you find out you might not even get to run at all next year, what does that mean?
It basically means that the district leaders are not giving us a chance at all, in a way. It's like it's almost like they don't want us to succeed in a way, but, you know, they do because they're trying to get it back. But it really hurts a lot of us out here.
You know, I can hear the disappointment in your voice. Well, the superintendent of the school district says that there was little choice out here. Back in February, the board voted to eliminate sports here just because of severe district-wide budget cuts. Parents have formed a committee called SOAP, Save Our Athletic Programs. They're trying to raise $720,000 to save sports, and they say they're still hopeful.
SOAP committee is just like the little train in that storybook. The little engine that could. So we're just going to keep going and going and going. $720,000 seems like an astronomical amount of money, but I really believe that this community can do it.
Well, that's pretty optimistic. And actually, they keep moving forward as though they can do it because you see they're still out here right now. They want to finish this season off strong. And parents and kids in this community say there are a lot of ways that you can help them out if you can. You can head to our website, kcra.com/morningnews, where you'll find contact information for the people you need to get in touch with. They've got a whole bunch of fundraisers planned in the next couple of months just to see exactly what they can come up with out here money-wise. We're live this morning in Fairfield. I'm Shara Kina Shams, KCRA3 Reports.
So this morning we're asking you, where should the funding for school sports come from? School districts, families, donations, districts and families sharing the cost. Those are your choices, and right now, districts and families sharing the cost in the lead. Log on to kcra.com/morningnews to take part, or you can email us your thoughts, morningnews@kcra.com.